All right, we got to move on. We got Jacktober to get into here.
Jacktober.
Let me get the official intro here for everybody.
That's what I want to hear.
That's what radio shows do. We should do that. We should do a little of that radio stuff every once in a while.
Happy Jacktober, everybody, from your friends at the Opie and Anthony Show.
One-third of the women polled said they do this right after a breakup.
My guess is tickle their clit with a rake.
It's a celebration of craptastic radio from around this great nation of ours.
A little more specific. That's pretty good.
That's the whole thing we did. She looks like every actress who was like a really hot teenager who's battling cancer later in life.
So turn up this turntacular radio. It's Jocktober on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Oh, boy. Just looking at their website, this is going to be a doozy today.
It's like Brother Elmo.
This is going to be a doozy. Brother Elmo's doing radio.
Wow, that is Connie and Fish.
Connie and Fish.
God bless them.
Out of Madison, Wisconsin, on Z104.
Which one's Fish?
Fish is the man.
Oh, okay. I thought maybe, you know.
No, yeah. Connie gets top billing.
It could be Conrad.
That's true.
Could be Conrad, and Fish could be the reason, you know.
That's true.
We all know. All know that.
In Ordinary People, that was what Donald Sutherland called Timothy Hutton. His name was Conrad. He called him Connie.
Connie. I just recently saw that movie for the first time in quite some time.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
We're burying our son.
Timothy Hutton is, and God damn that cunt, Mary Tyler Moore.
Holy Ice Queen.
Shit. She came out of, you know... Hello, hello!
Throwing her silly hat in the air.
Mary Tyler Moore throwing her hat in the air, being all fucking fun, Mary Tyler Moore. And she went into that movie and played just a despicable fucking piece of shit.
An ice twat.
Cold woman, man.
Very cold. To the husband, poor fucking, it was Donald Sutherland, right? Was the father?
Yeah.
Oh, you felt horrible for him. She was just a bitch.
And also Judd Hirsch was in that.
Yeah.
Timothy Hutton won the Oscar for that.
Timothy Hutton was really good, man.
Cried through the whole fucking movie. He didn't stop crying.
Like, I should have gotten a fucking Oscar then for my childhood.
That's one of those movies that's too depressing to watch.
It is depressing.
I can't.
Fuck! Hi, it's the girl that he met?
Yeah.
Oh, she killed herself last night.
Yeah, great.
And then he goes, yeah, it's called Judd Hirsch.
Right.
What? What happened? I talked to my son, David. My son, David.
You were stronger.
Yeah, yeah.
You held on. He let go.
That
was good.
Terrible.
Heavy fucking movie.
Yeah, really. Not light viewing.
Wait, no, not fun with your chick. Not a popcorn and blowjob film.
What's some of those popcorn and blowjob flicks?
What's some of the popcorn blowjob movies we
super
got?
Super bad.
Yeah.
You gotta watch Raging Bull after just to pick yourself up.
The movie didn't win the Oscar, though, right?
It won
Individual
Redford.
Performances won, but not the movie itself?
Redford won Best Director.
Director, right.
It won
Robert
Best Picture.
Redford.
Oh, it did win Best
Disgracefully
Picture.
Disgracefully so. And
what was it against the Cuckoo's?
Raging Bull.
No, Raging Bull. Oh, what did Cuckoo's Nest win?
Cuckoo's Nest won everything. It beat fucking Dog Day Afternoon.
Right.
And I think Godfather 2.
That's right. Okay, I was wondering why.
No, I apologize. It didn't beat Godfather 2. It beat Dog Day Afternoon.
Something that was like really...
Dog Day Afternoon it beat and something else.
Maybe that was it.
Cuckoo's Nest won it all, though.
Yeah.
Can we go back to covers?
Beat me.
Because somebody wants Jimmy.
Connie and Fish.
Somebody wants Jimmy to hear Shinedown doing Simple Man. And also David from Baton Rouge.
Baton Rouge, David.
This could be one of the greatest covers of all time right here. You got Spider Bait there, Travis. Give us a little Spider Bait if you got it queued up.
Oh. What the hell is that?
It's for Black Betty. Very good, Jimmy. Very fucking good. Give yourself a bell.
By the way, another Lead Belly song.
What?
Black Betty, Lead Belly. Oh, Black Betty, man, Black Betty.
Oh, Lord. This fucking version.
Oh, my God. Where's the still?
No kidding.
Holy shit.
Revenue coming.
Good, yeah.
Damn it.
I was singing through a walkie-talkie.
That's cool, like, though. It's a cool effect,
distorted.
Right?
Distorted. Nice.
That's enough of that. And then Shinedown doing Simple Man. And then we do some Jocktober, and then we get Jimmy out of here.
Yeah. It stinks. Overreacting idiot guy.
Guy.
Guy. Shit.
Overreacting idiot guy. It's got to be a character.
Well, Mama told me when I was young, said, sit beside me, my only son, and listen closely to what I say.
Does he turn his head to breathe?
And if you do this,
no?
It'll help you some sunny day.
This is good.
Scorch used to play this every day.
Oh, really?
Oh, shit. Look, it sounds like
the original or this version?
This version.
I've never heard of this. Oh,
that's pretty cool. I like
this.
This
is great.
Scorch's theme song, Simple Man.
Simple Ton.
Don't take your time. Don't live too fast. Troubles will come. They will pass.
Oh, changed up a little.
It's a little like torture.
You'll find a woman. You'll find love.
Can this be bought, this song?
Yeah. And don't forget that there is a song.
I'm making a cover.
I love fucking covers, yeah. For lack of a more boring thing
I'm
to say.
I'm going
to
put a cover set together for my cassette player.
For your cassette.
Yeah, I'm going to make a cassette of all covers.
Did I tell you what Florentine did one time to Elena when he was this girl Elena he was dating years ago? She was a school teacher, and he made her, she wanted some songs, so he made her like a cover of all of her favorite songs, but in between each one, he would put filthy dice bits so she couldn't listen to it with her friends. Like, he put, like, whatever the song was, like, you know, if you want to be happy for the rest of your life, and then Dice, let's talk about Ansi. So she couldn't play it in the car with her friends.
It's just a whole love song.
Ah, that's great.
That's awesome.
Funniest man ever. Kisser. He's the funniest guy ever.
Let's get some Jocktober because Jimmy's going to leave us in a few minutes here. So we got Connie and Fish on Z104 in Madison, Wisconsin. What we got on Connie and Fish there, Sam?
Well, Connie and Fish are, of course, the morning duo. They've been together for like 13 years.
Wow.
Married?
You'd think the way they get along, but no.
Love it.
They've been, you know, traveling across the country, and they finally landed in mornings in Madison, Wisconsin.
Oh. Madison, Wisconsin. And what type of a station?
It's actually a top 40 station. So
top
I'll give
40?
You some of today's best hits and mix it in with some of their personalities.
And we got to keep things, I think top 40, we got to keep things a little safe.
Keep things a little safe and do
so.
About an hour and a half on the Packers because...
Oh,
Wisconsin.
Once again, you got to go local.
Local people.
That's how they're competing with satellite radio. They tell everybody, just go local, because they can't do local.
Oh, right. Connie Fish, take a seat over here. Let me, just take a seat. Look, we want to keep things local, because no one else can do that. See, we can only keep it local. That's what we have. That's our asset. So, a lot of Packers. A lot
people
of Packers
love the Packers.
People love the Pack. Don't worry about it. And nothing dirty or anything. And Connie, you just keep Fish in line. Okay? Fish, I heard you. I heard you at the party. You can get a little crazy.
Yeah.
What?
Oh, you didn't see
it? There's a ridiculously good video of Nicole doing some kind of booty dance.
So we were just imitating the booty dance through the window.
As she walked by.
She's been emailing me.
Really?
No.
Look how we all went like, you motherfucker.
It felt so good to say that.
We were all like, you fucking son of a bitch. Do you have it?
Yeah. Just
oh, my God. You got it. Now,
dude, we're
going to
lose Jimmy before Jocktober,
no,
though.
No, Jimmy won't leave. Jimmy won't leave with this playing.
All right.
You got to see it.
Yeah.
Nicole.
Look at this. Look, watch this.
Nicole Bagan.
Go full
what
screen.
You
full screen.
Drop it low.
Look at this. Oh my God. Do you know what that would feel like? Do you understand what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm saying?
It's not your boobs. You don't pop your boobs.
Well,
you pop your butt.
It's a big. Do you fucking even understand? Look at that.
I can't drop it low. First of all, you're on your heels. You have to be on your tippy toes. All right.
Oh, my God. Mars, you like that?
Yeah, she looks retarded.
Retarded?
Why dare you talk about Nicole Biggins like that?
We're gonna have her redo it for our show.
I'd like to look retarded after that. Make your retard
Kenny,
face.
Kenny, tell
make
her tomorrow face. She's got to do it for our show. All right?
I love it.
What you, oh, look at
the guy. Yank the guy out?
You know, you killjoy. He's just sitting here.
We got to ask Nicole, why does she step in that bucket?
It's a box.
Yeah, why does she step in it?
Why not? Yeah. Exactly. Let her do what she wants. If she moves around like that, she could do whatever the fuck she pleases.
Let's get one Jocktober in before we lose Jimmy. We where were you, Sam? Connie and Fish.
It's just Connie and Fish. Sometimes, you know, they are a safe show, but they do tend to get a little wild. Oh, insert some humor in there.
Okay. Cool.
You know what I mean? To make sure people realize, hey, they're on the radio. They're not just your average duo. So I figured the first clip, you could just start with track one so Jim can get a sense of kind of the humor, where they're coming from. As a comedian, he would be able to.
And you're right. Connie and Fish come back from break. Yeah. Fish reacts to every emotion Connie says without a sound. It's very funny.
With a sound.
That's why it's so funny.
All right.
Now, back to Connie and Fish. C-104.
Welcome to Tuesday, everybody. Isn't it great?
Yes, Tuesday, the day after Monday, the worst day of the week, my friends. It's Tuesday.
Probably a lot of us are tired or hungover. Kind of sad. Or ecstatic. One or the other, probably. Whew.
I'd rather listen to that. I just wanted to put that out there.
That's a great new sound effect.
Thank you, sir.
That is fantastic.
Instead of listening to Connie and Fish, I would listen to this.
Oh, that's unbearable.
Yeah, well.
I love it.
Or this.
And
once
so
again,
bad.
that's the horn screamer.
Yeah,
being happy.
Yeah,
hate to hear how it sounds if it was angry.
Take that boat wherever you need it, young captain.
So, what do you guys think of Connie and Fish so far?
Good stuff,
Jimmy.
That was riffing. They were riffing.
They were just riffing. That's kind of, they kind of come back a little casual.
Did Jimmy tap out 10 minutes ago?
No, I hit a button on my phone and a song gets playing.
What
do you think of Connie and Fish?
They're good so far. I mean, it's got some laughs in there.
Macho Man.
Do we move right on, Sam?
It'd be embarrassing.
Yeah, I mean, the next clip, there, everybody's talking about David Letterman, you know.
Like topical.
Yesterday, we were playing audio.
Oh, we sure were.
Fish instead reads David Letterman's monologue because he probably, and then decides whether or not he thinks it's funny because he's in a position.
Well, you know,
tough customer.
Why not?
Yeah. Fucking grump. Oh. Here's Fish reading David Letterman.
Just shoot yourself.
It's my favorite bit. We can't explain.
Fantastic.
It's my favorite fucking thing.
Irrelevant lump. Boy, you just get cancer everywhere.
I hope he gets heart cancer.
Oh God!
Exactly. And sneezes. I don't know why. It's not supposed to stop your heart.
He just won't quit. We moved on months ago.
Worst body ever.
Oh, my God. I don't know what that is.
Horrible.
You guys are being mean to Fish.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, right.
Okay. Like body like a bloodworm.
Okay, well, I don't...
Let's talk about late night TV. Okay?
I like late night TV.
Late night TV. Cue that music.
Did you hear that music?
Yeah.
They also tell their show there's a lot of production.
Yeah.
That's in the Prep Burger section under late night theme.
Yeah.
Yes.
Exactly.
David Letterman didn't try to avoid a sex scandal on last night's Late Show. Mm-hmm. He even dedicated pretty much his entire monologue to it.
Yeah.
He opened up with three quick shots with a did your weekend just fly by? I'll be honest with you folks, right now I'd give anything to be hiking on the Appalachian Trail. And then, of course, I got in the car this morning, and the navigation, even the navigation lady wasn't speaking to me. Classic David Letterman humor. He's not a monologue guy, but those navigation ones kind of funny, to be honest with you.
You think?
Hey.
To be honest, I mean, Letterman usually not...
Thank God.
Funny.
Because I wasn't sure it was funny, Sam, but yeah. Fish is telling me it is. So,
not only that.
Kind of funny.
The fact that Fish is saying that Letterman is not a monologue guy.
No.
And he's been doing a monologue every day forever.
Dude, that monologue was hilarious.
Yeah. And he's kind of a monologue guy now. Yeah, maybe when he first started, it wasn't his thing.
But he did it.
But now he's kind of
good at it. How many years in training of reading a monologue does he have?
Well, he was a stand-up, dude. He did Carson.
Yeah, but I mean, he's kind of funny, but he's not Fish.
Yeah, I'll be honest
with you.
He's
not Fish funny.
Yeah, exactly.
Fish is funny.
Do you hear him making those noises? Oh. Ow.
That is so fucking obnoxious.
I want that goose sound.
It's great.
The what? Oh, this?
It's got ringtone.
You should come out on stage to that every night.
You know what? No. Ringtone, quiet car in the train. And you just play that full fucking blast.
That's a good idea.
And not listen to anybody say, shh.
Just look around. Whose phone is
good. Well, how great would that be? You have to go on, like, with a guy like Kenny, though, somebody who can protect you.
Yeah.
And just play that really loud.
You got a problem? Someone stands up and says something. Sit down.
Oh. You're going to have a problem if you don't sit back down.
Listen to the birdies.
You're going to hear birdies.
I gotta go, guys. I'm gonna miss my flight.
All right, Norton.
I don't like to miss Jocktober, but it's
safe trip.
Daddy got bills to pay.
Say hi to Mr. Leno.
Yes.
From us.
Yeah, please say hi to Jay.
I will, actually.
Did he get my gift?
I kept it.
Figures. Did he get it for real?
I don't know what you sent him.
Ask him.
Unless it's a car.
No, I don't know what it is. Yeah, he drives a different one to work every day.
I know. He's Jay Leno. He's a collector of all kinds of fascinating automobiles.
That's good, by the way.
I read his thing in Popular
Mechanics.
I'd hate
to see his car insurance bill.
Oh,
that's got to be just outrageous.
Oh, my goodness,
Opie. I'm leaving right now, but I had asked sales or somebody.
Yeah.
They brought me, and I had the WOW sticker up on the behind me.
Yeah. Yes.
And I said, they don't like logos. And they don't want to push it off as logos. So I said, get me one. Fuck all the other stuff. It just says Opie and Anthony on it.
Yeah.
I said, get me a black sticker with yellow letters that say Opie and Anthony, plain as day.
Thank you, Jimmy.
And I also had somebody change the Wikipedia page. So when you Google Opie and Anthony, the first thing that comes up is Can Be Heard Daily on SiriusXM Radio.
Perfect.
And there's no sticker to be found.
What?
So,
oh, my God.
I don't have what I asked for.
So... We're missing out on a great opportunity.
It's just it's
going to be on Leno tomorrow night, and an Opie and Anthony logo would really help the show and this fucking company.
It's mind boggling.
So what's going on with that?
I don't know. They're supposed to have it. I said I got to have it by Wednesday morning. And
does Steve know anything?
Well, stop right there.
Where's the fucking sticker?
Here. Oh. He clearly asked for it a couple days ago, and
I asked for it last week. Have you been following up and making sure it got done in time?
Eric was following up on it, and he gave them back. They did
nice
one
pass,
version
by the way. Nice pass.
I did see the version that they did, which you saw and wasn't correct, and then he brought it back, and no, they haven't produced another one.
No, I said just big.
Jimmy's leaving.
I know.
This is big for us.
It's not going to amount to. Well, here's the way I look at it.
Hill of beans.
Let's say it's an average Leno episode. Let's just say 6 million people watch it. It's a lot of people.
Yes.
If 1% sees the name and Googles it, that's 60,000 who might not have heard, who
Jesus
might go, where are these guys?
Christ.
That's the way it works. And if it's a 0.5%, it's 30,000 just checking it out. If a 0.5% of 1%.
Yeah, because mysteriously people would go, what the fuck?
Could you run down?
What is that?
Run down to Greenstein's office, go right to the fucking top and go, where the fuck is the sticker that Jimmy's leaving right now for the airport?
They could overnight it to me. And
it's ridiculous.
Where
I'll find out where it is.
Run.
He did say run, Steve.
Run.
Yeah.
I am running. This isn't hard.
I know.
Dude, you guys don't want to market us, all right, but Jimmy wants to, and he's on Leno. Let's go.
Sometimes I feel like a hippo on a treadmill.
Bye, guys. I'll talk to you Monday.
All right, Jimmy.
Bye, boys.
Have fun in Denver. Thanks, have fun on Leno.
Yes, right. Have fun, and be very careful. Look out.
Oh, of course.
A large percentage of people have herpes.
Oh, well, guess who's safe?
Fucking Jimmy.
It's the beauty of getting herpes. You don't have to worry anymore.
He's great.
All right, Sam, where are we at with this horseshit show?
Horseshit. Connie and Fish.
Oh, Connie and Fish.
Connie and Fish.
Oh, they get a little edgy here, I see.
Oh.
They're not afraid.
Been waiting for that.
They're not afraid to get a little edgy. That's the thing about Connie and Fish. That's what kind of separates them. You think they're just your typical blasé, sounds like every other terrible radio show, but no, not
they'll
these guys.
To the edge?
Yeah.
Push the envelope, as they say, or the envelope, depending on who you talk to.
I say envelope.
Envelope.
And here's
I always say
envelope. I say envelope, so.
Here's a bit we need to do.
Just pushing it.
Fish gets a little edgy.
Does he?
He talks about who he would like to switch bodies with.
What?
Well, the thing
that's
is...
That's crazy.
One of the things that makes their show unique...
Mars, sit in for Jimmy. I think you'll do a good job.
Oh, yeah.
I think you'd be terrific here in this spot.
One of the things that makes, Connie and Fish unique is that they'll pose...
As radio personalities? No. Oh, sorry. I thought you meant they would pose as radio personalities.
They'll pose a hypothetical question.
Yeah.
Discuss it amongst themselves for 5 to 7 minutes, and then ask the callers to call in with their opinion and take calls on it for 20 minutes,
Jesus.
Which is something you don't hear.
No.
Wow.
Never hear that.
No. You don't hear that.
Mars, more importantly, Mars,
yeah.
Who would you switch bodies with?
Connie.
What?
Just said Connie.
Yeah. Why would you switch bodies with Connie?
I want to be a morning show.
Is this the virus bit?
We're doing the virus bit.
It's the virus bit with Mars.
He slammed his hand down on the table saying, I got this one.
Very confident.
Mars. Yes, sir.
There's a rumor that E-Rock doesn't want to be the virus anymore. Would you step up and try to be the virus tomorrow using the same voice and everything?
Oh, I can't get the voice.
Yeah, you can. I'll coach you through it. He's got it. He's got this.
All right, think it over.
All right.
Yeah, Mars, your job depends on it.
Oh. But just, thanks a lot, OP.
But just think about it overnight.
Okay.
So who would you switch bodies with?
Anyone.
We're doing radio now.
Not just Connie or Fish.
You got to say something where the listeners are going to go, oh.
Really?
Yeah.
Steve Tyler.
The guy just broke his head.
You'd be laid up in traction.
He's got a terrible, out-of-shape body.
I think he's 62 and he looks like a grandma.
Why would you switch to someone older than you?
Did you see the latest picture of him?
No, I have not.
He literally looks like your grandma.
If you're figuring a rock star that's getting some pussy or something, go with a younger band and shit like
why
that.
Why Steven Tyler?
He's got a broken hip.
He might have an answer, though, Ant.
Yeah,
why
Steven Tyler?
Well, I always said to myself, if I was, I had a choice... And come back reincarnated as someone else. It would be
what?
Reincarnated? If I was reincarnated and I came back as someone else, it would.
Wait. You were what?
Reincarnated.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Reincarnated. Closer. All right.
It would either be Steve Tyler or Mick Jagger.
You know, but they're much older than you.
Really back in the day.
No, today. You don't have a time machine.
And
just
how
a body
could you come
switcher.
Back? How could you be reincarnated into somebody that's already here? If you die.
Or dead, since
or
they're
dead,
much older than you.
And then all of a sudden they're back again?
Yeah.
You're going to get reincarnated to 1965?
Yeah.
Oh. All right.
All right, we're going to play the Connie and Fish audio, and then you think about... This. Who you want to switch bodies with, okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And Steve's got some note that I'm not supposed to read on the air, but I certainly will. Give it to me.
I certainly will. He said.
We'll get it FedExed out to Jimmy in California. Who said that?
That was the marketing people.
Which one?
Do we even know them? Have we even met them?
Which one?
Yeah, I don't know.
We're one of their big shows. Maybe we should have met them.
This is one of the disadvantages of working in a big company is there's so many people.
Your mic's not on. They can't hear you.
Oh, come on.
Connie and Fish get a little edgy.
All right, here we go. 26% of American men say they would like to switch bodies with this person. Who is it?
26% of American men say they would like to switch bodies with this person.
Steve.
What person?
You gotta go with a girl with big tits, right?
No, that's a little too risque, I think.
Why?
I think they're gonna go with Brad Pitt, Tom Cruise.
I'm just talking among
like
us.
That.
If you're gonna switch bodies, why would you switch?
Right there, morning mashup. Fucking.
Send me that link. I gotta tweet that shit for the peeps.
I could absolutely spank it to that.
Yeah.
And I've never spanked, I think, to a. Fully
she does a horrible
girl.
Job, but
she's terrible.
But she has such a
but
fine
could,
body.
You can undress her with your eyes in there.
Because at one point it looks like she's bending down to take a shit.
which would be hot, too.
Do you think she realized when she was making that people are going to watch this and masturbate to it?
No, never.
Like, this is just like a fun sort of...
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, a lot of guys are going to watch this and masturbate.
Oh, a lot of guys are just going to spank away
yeah,
to that.
Nude in a chair
yes,
watching
just sitting cock in hand.
Yeah.
Jacking away.
Definitely.
Mars, people are curious. Would you want to be reincarnated into David Duchovny?
Person. Dave.
What person do you think 26% of American men say they'd like to switch bodies with? Who do you think?
I am not part of this percentage of men.
Oh.
Do you have somebody you'd like to switch bodies with? Julia Roberts.
Yeah, I know. That'd be kind of fun.
You'd stay home all day,
yeah,
I know.
Would. Yeah, yeah, I would. With my luck, I'd be on my period.
Yeah, well, that comes with being a chick, but you still get the fun bags to squeeze every
he
day.
He picks
between
a,
periods.
But he picks a chick that's so past her fucking
no,
prime.
That's the point.
Like, when did this come out? The 80s?
Yeah. This was yesterday. This was broadcast live yesterday.
You're going to go time. Down the... you would say Scarlett Johansson, Megan
Julia
Fox.
Julia Roberts.
She may not
Roberts.
Even have a period anymore.
Yeah, right. There's a good chance that she's dry.
Menopause.
There's a very good
Julia
chance.
Julia Roberts.
How old is she? Let's figure that out.
All right.
God, pop up IMDb. Find that shit out
all right,
in
Mars,
a second.
Did he come up with something a little more relevant for your what does he say? Reincarnation?
Yeah. Who he wants to be reincarnated as.
Reincarnated.
Well, if
sitting in for Jimmy, doing a great job.
I guess one of the MMA fighters, like GSP.
Ah,
what
MMA guy?
Yeah,
he's all got right.
A great body.
Ew.
Ew. So you could kick some ass.
See this, that too.
There's no real
that too. Like I would think, if you wanted to be an MMA guy, that would be the number one reason.
See, there's no good answer because if you pick like a quote hot guy, guys would go, wow, what you like his abs and shit. But then if you say a girl, then you go, what you want to be fucked by guys,
some dude.
So it's like,
yeah, but Mars
you can't
is,
win with this question.
Mars's explanation was, I'd pick GSP. He's got a great body.
Yeah, yeah right. Great body.
Julia Roberts is 42 years old.
42. So if you're going to change bodies with someone, you know, pick, like you said, Scarlett Johansson.
Someone's got some years.
If you're going to stay home, like he was speculating, and Fish was, or Connie was saying the same thing, that he would just be toying with himself.
Mm-hmm.
Like never leave the house. Yeah. Oh, Julia Roberts sitting there with her fucking, you know,
yeah,
and whatever.
And if Julia Roberts was a band, she would be doing her farewell tour right now.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
That shit is ready to go away.
Shit's just at the expiration date.
Oh, yeah. All right, well, Fish...
When in doubt, throw it out. I always say.
Fish comes off as extremely masculine and heterosexual as they continue.
Yeah, just like Mars just did just now.
Hey, Connie and Fish, what do you think the answer is?
Matthew McConaughey?
No.
Oh, good guess.
Not Matthew.
He's in shape.
Oh, no, he's
what
in shape.
The fuck?
Matthew McConaughey, yeah.
Oh, yeah, good guess.
Good guess.
What do you think of Matthew McConaughey?
He's a sexy looking guy.
What? What? Women like him. What?
Women like him.
Yeah, you know.
Wait, what's it, Matthew
the
who?
Chicks.
Oh, fuck.
What's his last name?
What is that? Matthew.
Come on, virus. Matthew. What's his last name?
Matthew.
What is it?
Matthew McConaughey.
Come on, you can do this.
Someone say it once for me.
Okay, Matthew.
Matthew.
McConaughey. I gotta see it, man. I can't. I gotta see it.
We've heard the name forever.
I know.
We just said it four times.
Matthew.
McConaughey.
McConaughey. I am from McConaughey tribe.
McConaughey.
One more try. I know he's got it this time.
He's got it.
Yeah. Tatanka.
Buffalo. Playing the part of the virus today, Mars.
McConaughey. I see it.
He's right.
McConaughey.
I guess he's Hawaiian.
Yes.
Matthew McConaughey. Let's listen to Fish.
No.
Oh, good guess.
Not Matthew.
He's in shape. That dude's in shape.
What do you think the answer is?
How about a pregnant woman to see how they are, you know, baby?
Yes, that's it.
Men are that dumb. Well, I guess this is only a quarter of men. So.
Yeah, so a quarter of men could be that dumb.
No, that's not it. Wait, haven't you always said that you wanted to be a pregnant woman?
Yeah, I'd be curious.
Or if you could be a man and be pregnant, you'd like to?
I think giving life like that would be pretty intense and pretty awesome, to be honest with you. That's my opinion, but what do I know?
You wouldn't listen to that radio show?
Holy shit, dude.
I couldn't turn it off fast enough.
I was so phasing out of that. I just started staring at one of the fucking news anchor girls on CNN.
He thinks that the process of giving life would be pretty awesome.
Giving life.
You know what? Let's go to our expert. Mars, what do you
giving
think?
Giving life.
Would you like to be a pregnant chick just to go through the experience?
I don't think so.
Why not?
It's a bad... I mean, shit.
Here we go. Why
you
not?
Endure too much during pregnancy.
Like what?
The pains, the cravings, the labor. Or like, labor. Don't want any of that. Nothing.
What are the good parts?
I don't know.
I hear they get hemorrhoids, too.
Do they?
Yeah. Come, the pressure pushes down.
Yeah.
And pregnant chicks get like hemorrhoids.
They do get really horny.
What?
They do. Yeah. Pregnant women do get really horny.
Yeah.
And what do you do about that, Mark?
You got to take care of
business. Being a man's man. What do you do?
But what if you hit the baby with your penis? No.
Pregnant pussy is good pussy.
Why is it good
pussy? How is that?
It's really, really tight. Mm-hmm. That area there gets really, really tight.
How does it get tight? It starts opening up.
No. Actually, before, and not... You're very close to labor.
Oh.
But prior to that, like 7-8 months.
Yeah.
Really, really
like
tight.
Like before the baby gets like 9-10 months.
Yeah. Yeah. How long is this gestation period?
I said 7-8 months.
7-8 months. Yeah. It's only 9 months.
Yeah. So you got a month.
So it's like, so you put your dick in there. What happens if you hit the baby's head, the soft spot?
That's not true.
Why is it not true?
Pregnant happens.
So they're in there.
Pregnant pussy rocks, huh? It's nice and tight. Except only if they're not showing. Only if they, yeah.
Yeah. No, even showing.
But why would they be showing it 7 or 8 months, you said? Before.
Oh, 7 or 8 months before they give birth?
That's what you just said.
When they're 7 or 8 months pregnant.
Oh, no, he's saying when they're 7 or 8 months pregnant.
So well, then you would hit the baby.
Yeah, then you'd hit the baby.
You would not.
Why wouldn't you? They come out of the fucking...
How small's your
they
dick?
They come out of there.
What the fuck? It hits the baby. Yeah. We all know that.
You got to hit the baby's head.
Right.
Hit the soft spot.
That's why babies come out blue. Schlong. It's all the bruising. Mars is my new favorite part of this radio show. Fuck the virus.
Yeah. Do you call yourself Mars because you can't say your last name? Is that it?
No.
Mars. Fuck it. Mars. Mars. Call me Mars.
All right, Mars. Yes. Matthew
McConaughey.
Oh, okay.
Well, give him a bell. All right,
close.
McConaughey. Fish tries to go in a different direction. We're looking at Connie and Fish for this Rocktober.
Jocktober, excuse me.
Today's Jocktober, right. Well, Fish tries to go in a different direction here, Ant, with the topic. Connie gives him nothing in return.
With these, as these clips progress, we're going to start seeing that...
progress.
Yes. They have...
Mars.
You could say progress.
No.
No. They have no chemistry, these two.
Okay.
Yeah, and by the way, Mars, pregnant pussy is tight pussy because that's actually the baby's mouth. So.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Mars.
Oh, Mars. Oh, God, Mars, what are you doing?
What the hell's wrong
it's
with you?
It's awful.
You wait for the kid to be born before you start doing that stuff, you sick
Mars,
fuck.
Shock jock you.
Mars is shocking.
It's a shock jock.
You, on the other hand, I know you didn't want to switch bodies with... George Clooney, but is there somebody that you, if you could switch with anybody?
Yeah, I'd like to switch bodies with George Clooney.
No, but I mean,
it'd be hot.
Yeah, I mean, is there somebody like if you could like, you know, do something, play a trick or work a magic thing or whatever,
no.
Switch bodies? No one.
I can't think of anybody. There are a lot of chicks with great bodies.
Jennifer Aniston has a great body.
Yeah, she has a good body.
You guys are like the same age?
She's okay. She's a couple years younger than me.
All right. She's close, though.
Or a year younger.
You know what I mean? Or would you want to, like, switch with somebody from, you know, that's, like, 20?
No.
God, they're getting nothing done.
Holy shit.
They're getting nothing
I
done.
I swear to you, I was dozing.
I'd rather hear the old Betty's talking about the dumb river and how they say good morning, good night to
good
it.
Good morning and good night. And I have a wonderful breakfast and make beautiful friends.
Old bat.
They have no concept of going with each other.
No, like fucking say something.
They figure.
What do you think? George Clooney? Yeah, George Clooney. you have a magic device of some sort that I can't even explain. But you change your body. What girl? Jennifer Aniston?
That's my favorite part, that he sets it up to move along. He's like, I know it's not George Clooney, but who would it be?
George Clooney. Yeah, George Jennifer Aniston, she's your age. No, she's a year younger. What? Who cares? Just say yes, Jennifer Aniston.
That means you're an old broad. Why would you admit that Jennifer Aniston is younger than the fuck's wrong
so
with
she
you?
Doesn't look bad.
Oh.
It's Connie. Yeah.
Let's
she
move
keeps
on.
It real.
The chemistry, Anthony, of Connie and Fish have...
That's great. Fucking oil and vinegar.
Wait, what did you write here? The chemistry Connie and Fish have none of starts to become...
Starts to become apparent.
Okay, as they banter about George Clooney, listen as Connie yawns at the end.
Always the mark of a good... It's not even like a pause and a yawn while he's talking.
Oh, no.
Oh,
and it's a loud yawn?
I mean, it's we can hear
it. Yawn, but I try to keep it off mic, especially if someone's... just
and Mars is filling in for Jimmy. Just a little advice.
Yes, sir.
You can't just smile the whole time. The mic is live.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's just smiling really big and looking around the room.
Every also, so often, you got to go, I'd like to be in the body of Albert Einstein. You know, just blurt something out in a TED voice.
Here we go.
Connie and Fish at C104FM.com.
Jumpstart Trivia is done. The question was 26.
All right, I got to stop because it sounds like this broad, what's her name?
Connie.
Oh, Connie. She doesn't want to be there.
No, she doesn't.
She sounds like she is miserable and doesn't want to even do the show.
The question was 26% of American men say they'd like to switch bodies with whom? Answer, George Clooney. I love the relationship that George Clooney and Matt Damon have.
No,
they always make fun of each other.
Is it, you mean George Clooney and Brad Pitt?
Oh, Brad Pitt.
Yeah.
Well, Damon's kind of in there too, isn't he?
Yeah, he's kind of like the little brother. He kind of seems like he's the little brother at least.
Brad Pitt is always calling George Clooney gay.
There are definitely two megastars.
I get a kick out of it.
Definitely megastars. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. I mean, seriously, talk about two megastars right now. That relationship that they have with each other,
mm-hmm.
Where they kind of mess around with each other, is pretty rare, though. I mean, it's pretty... A lot of people don't have that type of friendship, you know what I mean,
uh-huh.
Nowadays.
Fuck, would you shut up, Fish?
Is she a drinker?
I don't know what Connie's habits are.
What the fuck?
Fish is a dullard.
But he's at least trying. Trying to get something done. Look, whether it's going to be good or not, at least he's trying. She don't give a shit. She doesn't even want to be there.
You know what, though? No, I don't see that point. I see, here's
Are you
Fish.
Team Connie or Team
here's
Fish?
Here's Fish trying. Blah, 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 blah. I'm trying just as hard as Fish. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah. That's rare. That's
some kind of tricks, magic thing?
Magic thing that you have. That kind of megastars. They're megastars. Megastar, megastar, megastars.
Uh-huh. Shut up, Fish.
Because Connie goes, yeah, they're always calling each other gay.
Yeah.
And Fish is like, I'm not going to acknowledge that statement. I'm going
to
keep...
No, why would I run with that one?
Yeah, that's crazy to run with that.
Maybe they're doing two separate shows.
Yes. At the same time?
At the same time to save money for the company. So he's broadcasting on one channel, a station. She's on another.
Oh, maybe the online feed is a little bleed through.
Yeah, yeah. And then you just hear...
Okay.
I hate these two.
Oh, Mars.
Damn, Mars.
Decided to stop smiling for a second. What do you got on these two, Mars?
They just bug me.
Why do they bug you,
Mars? Wow.
Speak your mind. Connie and Fish, why do they bug you?
They're just so typical on-air radio show, you know,
What happened to the Jim Norton impression?
I lost it for a second.
Oh, you were doing Jim Norton there?
Yeah. My two lines of Jim.
Wow. This is the first time that you can actually hear someone smiling on the radio.
Yeah, he's... You hear like a little cotton mouth or something.
Yeah, and he's...
I need some water.
A little nervous?
I got
Absolutely.
Some. It's great.
This is what Mars wants to do.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to be an engineer.
No.
And he said, he always comes to me and he says, you know, I could do this shit.
I could do this.
I never said I could get on the mic and just
That's exactly what you said yesterday.
That's not true.
Instigator.
You want to put him in a lock? It's well within your means right now.
Boy.
Get up and do it.
No.
Sam, would you take one of the headlocks from Mars?
Mars can never get a headlock on me.
Oh, shit.
Oh, damn, no. You didn't just
Mars,
say that.
Mars, you going to allow that?
You didn't say that.
You just can't hurt him.
It will
snap
be
your
abuse.
Neck like a pencil.
You can't hurt him, that's all.
Kenny's right outside.
Kenny's not going to stop you.
No. I love Sammy. You can't hate the fucking
Sam,
guy.
Sam, what did you say?
I said Mars could never get a headlock on me.
I thought I heard that.
You can't hate
that. I thought I heard that. Mars?
You can't hurt.
Exactly. You can't hurt me.
He thinks you're fronting with your skills.
Right. Fronting.
Are you fronting?
Oh, no.
Are
you fronting?
What? Well, actually, I'm probably not as good as I thought I was. I got a little hurt last night.
Oh, what happened?
What happened?
Got a good arm bar yesterday.
Yeah?
Yep.
Fucked you up?
Yep.
Who gave it to you?
One of the black belts over where I go.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Gotta stay away from the black belts.
Yeah.
Well, that's how you get better, so. Yeah. But they get overzealous.
Which MMA fighter do you think has the hottest body?
That's a trick question. That's a trick question.
You gonna take that?
That's a trick question. There's so many attractive men.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I don't want any of them to get mad at me.
All right, here we go.
The arm bar, yeah.
Jacktober, Connie and Fish on Z104 in Madison, Wisconsin. Connie and Fish are not on the same wavelength at all as they talk about boomeritis.
That's right, boomeritis. It's the stuff that's affecting baby boomers where they're still acting like they're not as old as they are. They're still active, you know what I'm saying?
It's a new term, boomeritis.
Baby boomer?
Apparently baby boomers are trying to stay young, and so they're still doing things that they did when they were like in their 20s and 30s.
Like rollerblading or
playing tennis.
What the fuck's wrong with that? What, you're supposed to be an old guy?
You sit by the river and say good night every night and good morning in the morning.
What the fuck are you supposed to
do? Yeah, what's wrong with being active? What are you supposed to do? Start fucking playing bingo and shuffleboard and fucking sitting by the river like Ant said?
And rollerblading and tennis? My goodness.
Right. Sounds like you guys are starting to develop boomeritis.
I'll fuck you up. No, I didn't. I will fuck you up.
I got a little boomeritis going on.
And that's the
I
boss.
Mean, Mars might be a pussy, but I'll fuck you up.
That's the boss.
I know you will. I would never mess with open.
All right, thank you.
Headlock.
Mars sucks, though.
Sleeper hold.
Mars, he said you suck again.
Holy
what
shit.
What's wrong with you?
Those are just words.
That's right.
Really?
Sticks and stones, right, Mars?
That's right.
You going to allow that to happen?
How fast could you sleeper hold someone out?
Yeah.
It takes approximately 7 seconds.
7 seconds, and someone will be out.
Mm-hmm.
It's scary that he knows the
You just
the
get
answer.
It right in the crook there?
Mm-hmm. You cut
what
the...
do you do? You push down on the back of their head
mm-hmm.
like that?
Mm-hmm.
And they're out.
7 seconds.
7 seconds.
Fuck, I bet you cannot do that to Sam.
You can't.
Scary that he knows how much time. He didn't even, like, pause.
7 seconds. That's got to feel good when you lock someone in like that and go like, man, you are fucked
and
right
just
now.
You feel the body
you
go
are
dead.
And you feel the guy go like, Do they pull the Hulk Hogan, though, where you hold the arm up and it drops down 3 times, and then on the third time he keeps it up, and then he starts shaking?
It depends if the crowd at the dojo is chanting.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Mars, Mars, Mars.
And then
the hand starts coming out.
And then he goes crazy. He shakes.
Are you saying that Mars can't fight?
He can't fight me. I don't know what he does, but he can't hang with me.
What are you? Magic?
I got some kind of magic thing. Trick
thing?
Whatever.
Mega star.
He does, because Mars ain't going to touch him.
That's right.
Not going to touch him at all.
That's right.
He's in 30s.
Like rollerblading or
yes,
something
playing
like that?
Tennis, you know, doing whatever.
Good for them.
And so, well, no, because it's bad for their bodies. They can't do that anymore.
Oh, they need
they
to slow down.
They have to tone it down a notch. Yeah. But they're refusing to.
Are you one of those people that have you slowed things down that you typically would have done in the past?
Yes. I mean, you do notice it. I said to Dan when Dan was turning 30 a couple of years ago, I'm like, oh, just wait. Because he's always played on a basketball league in the winter.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, can't wait till this year's basketball league. Because he turned 30 in September.
Yeah.
And then started in October. And I'm like, I can't wait. He got his ass kicked that year.
Oh, sure. I remember that.
That year.
Yeah.
He was in pain, twisted ankles. Like, it's funny how you just hit a certain age and boom.
Are we listening to the new propofol?
There's no back and forth.
Wow.
Audio ambient.
Oh, my God.
It's on every morning. They've been together doing this for 13 years.
Holy shit. At least we faked that we still care.
I know. Come on.
Wow. You do a good job.
Thank you, Sam.
Say they You heard it yourself. I was right the whole time.
The boy P from North Carolina writes, is Mars eating his own ass? Tell him to get his mouth off the mic.
Yeah, you're breathing. Watch your heavy you breathe and your technique, too.
Not even on the mic. Fuck you.
Who are you saying fuck you to?
It's the feedbacker, I hope.
The feedbacker.
That's right.
Not Sam, of course.
That's right. All right. What do you got on that last thing, the boomeritis thing, Mars?
I wasn't even listening.
Why? You're in here.
I tuned it out.
What are you doing?
Why do you say that?
Oh, sorry.
You're supposed to listen.
Okay.
Mars has boomeritis.
Sammy Sam.
Boomeritis.
Sammy Sam.
All right, the final cut here, Anthony. October 09. Today we feature Connie and Fish on Z104 in Madison, Wisconsin. Connie and Fish show how good they are by taking an interesting topic like fucking 20-year-olds and moving the conversation to stretching.
You got to pump it up. You know how sometimes a caller will call up and just drop something in your lap, like a topic, and you're like, wow.
Yeah, you're like, thank you.
We could riff on this for an hour.
Yeah, listeners are the best part of this show sometimes.
Well, this is kind of, you know, Connie and Fish taken in a different direction than you guys might.
What is that?
Like, for instance, if a caller called up and started talking about, like...
Oh, fire alarm's going off.
If a caller called up and started talking about, like, having sex, and then it led to you having sex with a 20-year-old,
right,
where would you guys go? Probably talk about that for a little while?
Yeah, yeah.
What about stretching?
Riff on that.
Talking about stretching? Like, if you stretch?
Fire alarm's going off.
We're all right.
You sure?
Yeah.
What if... Look, everyone's evacuating.
Oh, no.
Hey, D-Boy's here. What the fuck?
Yeah, no.
It's not a fire. It's just the LQ guys walking by.
Oh, boy. Those are our friends now, Opie.
Flaming enough, right? I set off the sprinkler system.
That's my flame bit today. Thank you. Thank you.
Those are our friends.
Nah, I don't mind the guys. They actually held the door to the bathroom yesterday. I think we're making progress with those guys.
That's not really good, though, when they hold the door to the bathroom for you.
Mars is really, really good friends with them.
Are you, Mars?
They're good guys.
All right.
What? I'm friendly. What?
I didn't say...
How friendly are you?
Exactly. He was the first one here to be friends with those guys.
You got to make friends around the new environment.
I didn't say it was a bad thing.
Shit.
Who don't you like? You're free to speak.
I like everyone.
No, that's not true.
Who don't you like? Name one person you don't like around here. You're free to speak. It's fine.
I don't have any names, no.
That's not true.
There's no one that I dislike.
That's not true.
No.
All right, let's get the final track on here.
Yeah, let's...
Good morning, Cass.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hi. I tell you what, sex is still awesome, but I am not as agile as I used to be.
So that is the thing that you really notice the difference in.
What's that?
That's the thing that you really notice the difference in with your age.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Uh-huh.
Wow, really?
Yeah,
to move. See,
but Fish, you date people in their 20s, no, in their mid-20s, so they haven't hit that point
yet.
It's
not even just that, though, with me, Con. I lost a bunch of weight, so I'm actually more agile, probably, than I ever was.
Do you stretch?
Not enough, no. I really don't. I don't. I probably should. Everybody says I should.
You know something I noticed the other day? I was sitting on my couch, and I was trying to turn around and look at something. I noticed I can't turn my head as far anymore.
God, you're only 41.
I know, but I was like,
come on.
I used to be able to turn my head really far. I don't know. Maybe it's just paranoia.
I think it's paranoia. She's in the studio turning her head.
I'm going to go home angry now.
I'd like to turn her head like Schwarzenegger does in movies. Fucking what a babbling nothing.
She has decided at 41 that she's now old. A lot of people make that mistake.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Well, she's also overweight.
Keep going till everything hurts.
Is she a fat pig?
Yeah, I mean, you guys are both in immaculate shape.
Thank you, Sam.
She's on the chubby side of things.
Yeah, she is a little chub.
Yeah.
She's hiding behind Fish.
Mars, exactly. Comment?
Yeah, Sam's a fucking brown nose, man.
What? You don't think Obi and Anthony are in good shape? Wow, Mars, you are.
They're in good shape, but you said immaculate shape?
Look at him.
Wow.
Look at him.
You know, you don't have to fucking put it on a level there, Mars. You could say,
wow,
you know,
Mars.
He says immaculate. You don't have to fucking argue the point.
Yeah, what the fuck?
We might know, all right, it's not immaculate, but, you know, I appreciate it, Sam. You don't have to in there with a dose of reality there, Mars.
I didn't realize. I wish I had the job security that Mars does, apparently. Wow.
Apparently,
you know, I'm not the one with the fucking wrap on my elbow either, my friend.
Yeah, Mars, I got a little something for you, my friend. Mm.
What's that say?
You let that fucking elbow heal of yours. I'll let this trout flu heal on me. And we're gonna do that physical fucking test that you had to do in school.
All right. Well, the president's physical fitness challenge.
Me and you. I challenge you to the what?
The president's physical fitness challenge.
Yeah.
Only one man is going to walk out of here with a presidential seal.
I challenge Mars. Yeah. How old are you, Mars?
43.
Oh, wow. You look older than me. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, you look much older.
I can't take you on. That's not.
Nah. Why not?
I'm a lot younger than that. It's not fair.
Let's do push-ups. Let's do push-ups.
How many can you do?
I don't know.
How many did I do in front of that Marine that time, Kenny? How many did I do? 50?
Do I need to remind you he beat out a Marine doing push-ups?
Kenny. Right on the street.
And I would say...
Look up the video if you
don't
believe it.
That it's safe to say that Opie has less body fat than you do.
Oh, for sure.
Okay.
For sure.
Yeah, we all see the chub, Mars.
That hurt.
Thanks, Soap.
It might be your wife's cakes. They are delicious, but you could say no every once in a while. Fuck Sam, I'm going to get smashed.
What does that challenge entail? Push-ups, sit-ups, running?
We could do the push-ups. I think you had to do a little pull-up thing.
Oh,
what else did you do
in
that?
If it's a challenge in respect, you're going to lose, Morris.
Oh, wow. Shit.
Damn. There goes Kenny.
Kenny's talking some smack now.
Kenny's in my corner. Who do you got? Who do you got?
Obviously no one.
There might be some double dutch involved, too.
Double dutch.
What?
Isn't that? We didn't go to a ghetto school, Sam.
All right, well.
We went to a very white school system.
Well, there was double dutch in my school.
Yeah, I understand.
I don't know where all this aggression is coming from with Mars.
Yeah, me neither.
Well, we kind of bummed Jimmy had to leave early. That's where the aggression is. We thought fucking Mars would sit in and then do some good radio for 20 minutes. Boy, were we mistaken.
Yeah.
And Mars. Love this guy.
Thank you.
I do love you, Mars.
I love you back.
Not in that way, though. So
of
relax.
Course not.
Sorry, Mars.
That was good.
Bad news for you.
All right, that was good.
I think Mars did a good job sitting in.
Thank you.
Yeah. We talked about being reincarnated.
Mm-hmm. Matthew.
Matthew McConaughey.
How do you say his name again?
Matthew McConaughey. McConaughey.
Hey, you put some spell on us trying to say his name?
Matthew McConaughey.
McConaughey.
Oh.
McConaughey.
Say it. You had it right there.
Yes, I did.
All right, say it.
Matthew McCartney.
McCartney.
That's
great.
Yeah,
McCartney.
It's
great. It's Paul's younger brother.
It's really good, Mars.
They're going to cut us off, so what do you got?
Yeah.
Matthew McCartney.
McCartney is
McCartney,
correct.
McCartney, yes. Yeah. Matthew the Carney.
Mm-hmm. Matthew.
He's not in today's paper.
He might be in the back.
he's hoping. He's hoping his name's in the paper.
Matthew.
McCartney.
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 Well.
Matthew Macaroni. Matthew Macaroni.
If you're enjoying the stupidity, make sure you listen tomorrow because Rich Voss is stopping by.
All right.
Maybe a little competition between Mars and Rich Voss.
And he knows
that might have
stupid.
To go down. Mm-hmm.
We'll see who mispronounces the more words.
The more words. He said the more words.
The more words.
Fucking Mars.
Fucking Mars, you rule.
You do rule.